Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Phyllaris Tirich. Today we are going to look at English Form 2, Lesson 1. Our topic today will be on grammar and the subtopic will be on verbs. We'll begin by the lesson objective. By the end of the lesson, I expect you as a learner to be able to define a pronoun, state the different categories of pronoun, identify and explain how personal pronouns indicate number and person. So we'll begin our lesson with the definition of a pronoun, and you can say the following. A pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. The noun that is replaced by a pronoun is referred to an antecedent. The noun that is replaced by a pronoun is referred to an antecedent. We have functions of noun. Pronouns can function as subjects, object, and they can also indicate ownership. We have categories of pronouns: personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, relative pronouns, reflexive pronouns, emphatic pronouns, and demonstrative pronouns. We also have reflexive pronouns. These are pronouns which refer back to the subject of a sentence. For example, they really love themselves. And when we talk of emphatic pronouns, they're the ones which emphasize on something. She bought the book herself. Herself is an emphatic pronoun. A relative pronoun is a pronoun which is used to refer to a noun mentioned earlier. For example, this is the boy who won the race, who refers to the boy. So when we talk of relative pronouns, these are pronouns which have been used to refer to nouns that they have been mentioned earlier in the conversation. And when we talk of demonstrative pronouns, these are the ones which are used to point something specific within a sentence. For example, this is a book. This is a demonstrative pronoun because it tends to point which one? This one. If we look at personal pronouns, these are types of pronouns that mainly refer to persons. Personal pronouns can indicate number or person. When we talk of number, the number of a pronoun refers to whether the pronoun is singular or plural. The pronouns which are used when referring to one person, animal, or thing are said to be singular in number. The pronouns used when referring to more than one person, thing, or animal are said to be in plural in number. We can look at the example of singular pronouns are the plural pronouns. I is a singular singular pronoun. And in the plural pronoun, I changes to we, me, to us. He, she, he changes to they. Him, her changes to them. Whereas you appears either in its singular form or in its singular form and in its plural form. When we talk of persons, we have three types of person: the first person, the second person, and the third person. The first person is the person communicating. The first person is I, the second person is you, whereas the third person is the person being talked about or the person being spoken of. First person includes I, me, we, us, and our. I am reading a novel. I'm the first person. Please give us a drink. It's still in its first person form. The message was directed to me. It still refers to its first person speaking or writing. When we talk of the second person, it refers to the person who is spoken to or listening or reading. Example, you, yours. You are my neighbor. This is the second person who is being spoken to. The person that is the person listening or reading. Those books are yours. Yours is in the second person. The third person, this refers to the person or a thing being spoken about. Example of words that are used with the third person include the word he, his, him, she, her, has, it, its, they, their, them, and theirs. Example, she comes to school early. That's the that's the person being talked about. The girls are looking for her now. Now, the girls are looking for her now. This, for her is our third person. That's the person being talked about. That's how I've seen the singular plural and the singular pronoun and their plural form. I to me, me to us, my to our, mine to ours. You remains a you. You are can also remain you are yours to yours. Third person we can use in their singular form, he, him, his. That is the masculine form. She, he, she, her, has refers to the feminine, whereas it and its is a neuter. That means it's not either in its masculine or feminine form. And we can see their plurals. I want you to check on the following assignment. Provide the correct pronoun. You can also refer this to Excelling in English, Students Book 2, second edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can also reach us on the following platforms through our SMS line, the number posted on YouTube, Elimu TV, Facebook, Elimu TV, Twitter @Elimu_TV_KE. Thank you very much.